If you want to learn how to weld exhaust pipe in your garage, check this out. Now, the most important thing that you're going to need is a MIG machine. Any of them that'll work, you can get them that plug into 120, or if you have 230 in your garage or anywhere that you're at, you can run 230. So this machine here will do 120 and 230, depending on what you got it plugged into. The wire that I recommend using is a smaller diameter rod. This one is 0.030, and the kind that you're going to want to use is ER70S-6. So if you're having trouble setting your MIG machine up, if you open the door on your machine here, there'll be a chart. You're going to need the thickness of what you're going to be welding on, the type of gas you're using. So the type of gas that we are using is 7525, which is 75% argon, 25% carbon monoxide. So you'll come over here, find out what gauge you're on. For an example, we're going to be on some 16 gauge, and this is going to be wire speed 135 and volts is 16.5. So the wire that you're going to want to use and the bottles that you're going to use, you're going to get those at your local welding supply store. So more than likely, when you're welding on your exhaust, it's going to be already installed in your vehicle. A lot of times people are wanting to cut out their muffler and put a new muffler in or whatever the case may be. Right now we have this on a table. It's really easy to get to. Under your vehicle, it's going to be a little bit more difficult. But I do recommend cleaning off your pieces the best as you can, maybe with a wire wheel on a grinder, or if you can't get that in there, maybe a hand brush too, to get that a little as clean as possible before you weld on it. It'll just make your life a little bit easier. After you got this prepped up as best as you can, we're gonna go ahead and line it up and go ahead and throw a tack on this. We're gonna put one tack on it right now just to make sure that everything looks good before we put more than one tack. So let's go ahead and put a tack on now. Now, after you put that first tack in, you're gonna know if you're gonna be too hot or too cold, so adjust your voltage and wire speed accordingly. Again, if you have doubt, go ahead and open a door on your welding machine, and there will be a graft in there that'll get you close to what you need to be. So, now that we got a tack on it, we're gonna go ahead and kinda look around, make sure everything else looks fine, make sure you're straight, make sure your high-low is out of it. For those of you that don't know what high-low is, it's when your ends are not correctly in line with each other. So you wanna make sure everything is nice and straight. Once you like that, we can go ahead and put a second tack on it. Once it's still looking good, we'll go ahead and put a third tack on it. Okay, at this point in time, it should not go nowhere, and we go ahead and start welding. You're gonna find out with this, you're gonna want this gap as tight as possible. If you have any gap in there, it's gonna be a little bit more challenging to weld. One thing to remember, you don't wanna weld constantly. What's gonna happen is it's gonna get too hot on this thin metal, and it's gonna burn through. You're gonna have a lot of burn throughs. So what I like to do is to go ahead and spot weld. So spot weld basically means this. I'm gonna stop and go, stop and go, stop and go. So I'm letting it cool for just a second and then starting back up. That's gonna control the heat a lot better. Now that we got everything tacked up, everything is lined up, now we can go ahead and start welding. Just like that, we have it welded. Now your car will either sound better or louder, whichever you prefer. So this is basically for any intro, even though you're not really a welder, but if you know a little bit about welding, this is a pretty easy process to fix your own exhaust in your garage. So remember, until the weld cools, keep it hot.